the name of this discussion we call racial justice and policing. Let's remove the word justice here. The term in itself, we know what that means, but in a way, there is no justice within policing when there is no accountability.
What was for a long time missing from this conversation was imagination.
Black abolitionist scholar Ruth Wilson Gilmore talking about abolition is not just about absence, but it's about presence, right? And it's about building life-affirming institutions.
I think COVID has laid bare the fact that we live in an incredibly inequitable world, inequitable city, inequitable province, inequitable country.
Racism started with history, institutionalized discrimination against racialized and indigenous communities all across the world.
Part of what we need to do is to get rid of mandatory minimum sentences, which have not kept Canadians safe. And the only thing that they've done is dramatically increased the overrepresentation of racialized Canadians, particularly Indigenous and Black Canadians, in our prisons.
How can lessons on race and racism fit or relate to the bigger picture of capitalism and white supremacy?
So when I think about the obstacles, it's everything for us. Everywhere we look, everywhere we turn, there is an obstacle that was specifically put in place to deny us that right to education.
We were able to, in the last term of the FCM board, establish a committee on anti-racism and equity. And in that committee, we have been sharing a number of best practices across all the municipalities across the country.
So one of the ways that we're doing that is through the development of an anti-racism framework so that we make sure that public servants are fully equipped to apply anti-racism considerations.
The challenge I find today is around the homogeneity of the gatekeepers, not just in race, which is white, but also in class, which is mostly middle class, upper middle class, and also in geography.
There are over 600 different reserves in the country, over 60, I think like 60 different indigenous languages. What works in the East doesn't work in the West. What is happening in the North isn't happening in the South.
We hear a lot of nice things that employers say, but not really a lot of action. And I think we're now at a moment where we need to start demanding action.
If we don't have a seat at the table, if our voice isn't at the table, then how can our issues ever be addressed or ever be acknowledged or ever be recognized?